Number two, give me number three. Towards the end, number four. number 5, number 6, number 7, number 8, I see that hand, number 9, number 10, I need 11, 11, thank you, thank you. And what you do is, and this is all random, you blow out any candle except for the big boy in the middle. You don't touch that one, that's for somebody else. And just come up to it and just put your hand behind it and it'll blow out the candle. That's all. It's no big, these are not mysterious. These are Dollar General, 97 cents. Lowe's, plastic. But they're sacramentals. What is a sacramental? St. Augustine says a sacrament is an outward sign corresponding to an inner reality. So the reality we're speaking about is the light of the Spirit of our Lord Jesus Christ as he goes through the way of the cross, and it gets drained out of him until we come to the 12th hall. That's what it is. Okay? Yeah. An outward sign corresponding to an inner reality. For instance, see this ring right here? That's an outward sign corresponding to my wife, who's over there. And if I don't love my wife, this is a phony. You understand? Yeah. And if you don't know Jesus, the candle means nothing. It's just decoration. But if you come here and you know him, then you place meaning to it, because the sacrament is an outward sign. And the stations are all outward. Don't they look great? Look at that. And I want to thank Miss Terry Weed, who's conducting for me. Look at that, it's wonderful. Turn around, the light is right on you, it's wonderful. Yeah, I love it. Hey, let's start with, were you there when they crucified? You're gonna get this thing also. The first verse, we'll do it with oohs. Matter of fact, just give me the men. Just the men singing the oohs. It's always wonderful. Way of the cross.
Thank you.
Stations of the Cross were written by Pope Benedict back in 2005 for his good friend John Paul. And they're just glorious the way he wrote these. And the pictures we'll be using are from the movie The Passion of the Christ. And then we'll be singing different selections of songs in and out, and you'll get the same also. If you have your phone on right now, it would be good if you turned your phone on, especially if we have an Amber Alert. Yeah, we had one of these a couple of weeks ago. This is about the sixth time I've done this so far this season, and an Amber Alert overrides any. You have to pull the battery out. So it would be good if you turned your phone off now. That's good. The other ingredient that makes this so special is the word silence. Silence. Because that's where the Lord speaks. You know the word. The word of God says, be still and know that I am God. And that word be still doesn't just mean... No. Be still means to surrender. The word means to let your hands fall to the side. And when that happens, his presence fills a heart that's void. This is not worship. This is not a concert. This is worship. And so avail yourself in the person of the Holy Spirit as he moves through these wonderful stations. So let us begin. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. And let us begin with the prayer of Pope Benedict. Lord Jesus Christ, for our sake you became like the grain of wheat that falls to the earth and dies, so that it may bear much fruit. You invited us to follow you along this path when you told us the one who loves his life shall lose it, but the one who hates his life in this world will keep it for eternal life. Yet, Lord, we are greatly attached to our life, but you go before us, showing us that it's only by giving away our life that we may save it. So as you accompany us on the path of the grain of wheat, help us to discover what it means to lose our life. And sing this with me. Let us begin with just the men.
Behold, the word of the cross, on which is hung.
died before on the Last Supper. At around the table, Jesus tells his best friends that I greatly desire to share this Passover with you. And it's usually around the meal where you speak your heart. These are his final words, his final instructions. And here, this is where Judas abruptly leaves. The scripture says he raises the bread and he prays the Jewish prayer. And to their amazement, he adds these words, "This is my body, broken for you." And then he raises the cup, the chalice, prays the Jewish prayer, "Fruit of the vine, work of human hands." And then he adds these words, "This is my blood of the new covenant, my very life to be shed for you." And then they all said, "Well, now we know you come from the Father." And in the background, he hears them wondering who will be the greatest in the kingdom. And at this point, he gets down on his knees, aprons himself, and starts washing their feet. Scripture says they sang a hymn, but they remember him saying this one word to them. He said, "My soul is greatly troubled, even unto death." They left the upper room, went down to the Kidron Valley, over to the other side, a favorite spot where Jesus would pray. It's still there, overlooking the city. It's called Garden of Gethsemane. The word Gethsemane means olive press. And this is where the very soul of our Lord would be pressed. Here's where the tempter returns. And you hear the Lord crying out to his Father, "Abba, Father, if there is another way," while all his best friends fell asleep. Scripture says that in agony, he would sweat blood. But the battle of the cross was really won upon his knees right there in Gethsemane, when he says, "Not my will, but what you want, my Father."
Oh,
You don't have to keep clapping. And though the soldiers appeared in the night with torches, and for 30 pieces of silver, Jesus was betrayed by his old friend Judas. And here he gives Jesus a kiss in order to identify him. And then our Lord is apprehended. Scripture says that in the struggle, one of the guards had his ear cut off by Peter. But Jesus turned and healed him. And while Jesus is arrested, all of his closest friends run away and desert him. And then the guards grab Jesus away. They tied him up, they beat him, brought him to the Jewish authorities for questioning. And there he was questioned, mocked, hit, slapped, ridiculed, spit upon, and accused by his own people. Yet during all this, he kept silent like a lamb. Jesus next was brought before the Roman governor, Pontius Pilate, and then King Herod. After they questioned him, they found none of the accusations against him to be valid. Each of these rulers refused to condemn him, as his people demanded. But when the people became unruly and demanded the death of Jesus, Pontius Pilate called in the troops to control the crowd. He then offered them a deal. He had another man named Barabbas, who was imprisoned for murder. He offered to free one of the accused prisoners, whoever the people would choose, either Jesus or Barabbas, a murderer. But to his amazement, the people chose Barabbas, and Barabbas was unshackled and given his freedom. The people still demanded the death of Jesus, but Pilate vehemently refused, and instead, he commanded that Jesus be severely chastised. So Jesus was taken away to a regiment of Roman soldiers. And these soldiers handcuffed Jesus to a post and whipped him mercilessly. His own family watched as Roman soldiers finished the 39 lashes. And when finished, the soldiers set him aside and they put a crown of thorns upon his head. They put a robe across his body, and then they marked him as their great king. And after Jesus was severely beaten, he was presented again before his people. But his own people still demanded that he be crucified. So in order to prevent a riot, Pilate consented and sentenced Jesus to be crucified. And here, Pontius Pilate washes his hands in the sight of the crowd, and he proclaims, "I am innocent of this man's blood." And now we come to the first station. Jesus is condemned to death. He blew out the first candle. Let us pray together. We adore you, O Christ, for by your cross you have redeemed the world. Let us pray. Lord, you were condemned to death because the fear of what other people would think could not suppress the voice of your Father within. And so too throughout history, the innocent have always been mistreated, condemned, and to this day, some are still being killed. How many times have we ourselves preferred success to the truth, preferred our reputation to justice? Strengthen the quiet voice of our conscience, your very voice, within our hearts. Jesus takes on his cross. We blow the next candle. As we pray together, we adore you, O Christ, for by your cross you have redeemed the world. Let us pray the prayer of Benedict. Lord, you willingly subjected yourself to mockery and to scorn. Help us not to align ourselves with those who look down on the weak and the suffering. Help us to acknowledge your face in the lowly and the outcast. May we never lose heart when faced with the contempt of this world which ridicules our obedience to the voice of your will. Jesus was made to carry this cross out through the city and up a hill. The path is called the Way of Sorrows, the Via della Rosa.
Down the Via Dolorosa.
Mary, his mother, presses through the crowd, stops everything in order to comfort her son. But the Lord is forced to continue, and she is left alone. And maybe here, probably, maybe she remembers the words that were spoken directly to her over 30 years before by the prophet Simeon. When he told her, "Behold, this child, Mary, is destined for the fall and the rise of many in Israel. He's been sent as a sign from God, but many will oppose him. And as for you, Mary, a sword will pierce even your very soul." Let us pray. At the hour of the cross, the hour of the world's darkest night, Mary, your mother, remained faithful even when the disciples fled. Lord, teach us also to believe and grant us the faith which bears courageous fruit and be the sign of a love that's ever ready to suffer. Thank you.
Seventh station. Jesus falls for the second time. As we blow out the next candle, we pray. We adore you, Lord Christ, for by your cross you have redeemed the world. Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, you have borne all our burdens and will continue to carry us. Lift us up, for by ourselves we cannot rise from the dust. In place of a heart of stone, give us a heart of flesh, a heart that's capable of feeling and seeing. Lift us up, so that we may lift others up. Eighth station. Jerusalem born for Jesus. Let us pray together. We adore you, O Christ, for by your cross you have redeemed the world. Let us pray. Lord, to the weeping woman, you spoke of repentance, the day of judgment, when all of us will stand before your face, the judge of the world. Grant that in the end, we will not be dry wood, but living branches inside of you, the true vine, bearing fruit for eternal life.
Thank you.
We come to the ninth station. Jesus now falls for the third time. As we blow out the next candle, we pray together. We adore you, O Christ, for by your cross you have redeemed the world. Let us pray. Lord, your people often seem like a boat about to sink, taking in water on every side. In your field, we often see we see more weeds than wheat, which throws your church, the body of Christ, into confusion. Have mercy on your church, for within her tomb, Adam continues to fall. You stood up, you arose, you can cause us to rise. The tenth station. Jesus is stripped of his garments. And as we blow out the next candle, we pray. We adore you, O Christ, for by your cross you have redeemed the world. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, you were stripped of your garments, exposed, cast out of society. You took upon yourself the shame of Adam and you healed it. You also take upon yourself the sufferings, the needs of the poor, outcast of our world. In our nakedness, clothe us in the light of your grace. After stripping Jesus of his clothes, they made him lie down on the cross, and then they tied him down into it and nailed spikes through his hands and then through his feet. And then the soldiers lifted him up and hung him there for all to see. And that takes us to the 11th station. Jesus is nailed to the cross. We pray together. We adore you, O Christ, for by your cross you have redeemed the world. Let us pray the prayer of Benedict. Lord, you let yourself be nailed to the cross, accepting the cruelty and the suffering, the destruction of your body and your dignity. May we never flee from what we're called to do, but remain faithful. Unmask the false freedom that would distance us from following hard after you. Help us to stay bound and fastened to you in order to discover true freedom. Some in the crowd mocked him, saying, "If you are the Christ, come down from the cross so that we may see and
believe. Others said, he saved others, why doesn't he save himself? And as Jesus hung there, the Roman soldiers gambled for his remaining garments. Two other men were crucified along with Jesus, one on his left, one on his right. The man crucified on his left hurled insults at Jesus, while the man on his right said to Jesus, Master, remember me when you enter your kingdom. To which Jesus replied, today you shall be with me in paradise. Only a few remain in those final hours. And here's where Jesus gives John the responsibility to care for his mother after he's gone. Then Jesus looks up and cries, screams, Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani? My God, why have you forsaken me? Today's song. And many believe in this last hour as he hung on the cross, Jesus was praying within his heart a psalm that had been written by his great relative, King David, over 1,000 years before, prophesying this day. Psalm 22. Listen to Psalm 22. My God, why have you forsaken me? Why are you so far away when I groan for help? Every day I call to you, my God, but you do not answer. Every night you hear my voice, but I find no relief. Our ancestors trusted in you, and you rescued them. They cried out to you, and they were saved. They trusted in you. They were never disgraced. But I'm a worm, I'm not a man, scorned and despised. Everyone who sees me mocks me. They sneer, they shake their heads, saying, is this the one who relied on the Lord? Then let the Lord save him. If the Lord loves him so much, let the Lord rescue him. Yet you brought me safely from my mother's womb. You led me to trust you at my mother's breast. You led my God. My God, from the moment I was born. But now my life is poured out like water. All my bones are out of joint. My heart is like wax melting within me. My strength is dried up like sun-baked clay. My tongue sticks to the roof of my mouth. You've laid me in the dust. You've left me for dead. My enemies, they surround me like a pack of dogs closing in on me. They've pierced my hands, my feet. I can count all my bones. My enemies stare at me and they gloat. They divide my garments among themselves and they throw dice for my clothing. But the whole world shall acknowledge the Lord and return to him. Future generations will tell of the wonders of our God. O Lord, do not stay away. You are my strength. Come quickly to my aid. It is finished. The 12th station. Jesus dies on the cross. We pray together. We adore you, O Christ, for by your cross you have redeemed the world. And after 6 hours of torment, Jesus cries his last words, "Tetelestai," it is finished. And then scripture says he willingly gave up his spirit.
And he died for us.
Lord Jesus, at the hour of your death, the sun was darkened. At this present hour in history, we're living in God's darkness. Through your great suffering and the wickedness of men, the face of God, your face, seems obscured and unrecognizable. And yet on the cross, you have revealed yourself. This is your face. At the hour of darkness and tribulation, scripture says at that moment, there was a shaking in the earth, and the curtain in the temple was torn from top to bottom. A Roman soldier pierced the side of Jesus with a spear, bringing forth mortar and blood. Jesus is taken down from the cross. Let us pray together. We adore you, O Christ, for by your cross you have redeemed the world. Let us pray. Lord, you descended into darkness and death. In the hour of our darkness, help us to know that you are still there. You will not abandon us when we're tempted to lose heart. Give us the fidelity of Mary to withstand those moments of confusion and the love that's ready to embrace you in our helplessness. And here's where Mary receives her son again. Much like at the very beginning over 30 years before, when she held that man. What child is this who lives? Mary's lamp is sleeping, with angels wreathed with anthems, while shepherds sons bold and myrrh, come peasant, come king, come to mourn him. The King of Kings, salvation he brings. Let loving hearts enthrone him. Pale as a spear will pierce in through, the cross he'll bear for me and for you, so. Hail, hail the Word made flesh, once a baby, the Son of Mary. For this is Christ our King, shepherds once God and angels sing. Haste, haste to bring him now, as a baby, the Son of Mary. Said, for unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given. this with your mouth. Because it was cursed.
And so he bought an expensive linen cloth to wrap the body, along with Nicodemus, who came with a mixture of myrrh and aloe. They prepared the body and placed it in a new tomb and left. Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, in your burial, you've taken on the death of the grain of wheat. From the tomb shines forth into every generation, into every season, the promise of the grain of wheat, which has the ability to rise into true manna, the bread of life. You are that bread of heaven, our source of life. Now help us to become living witnesses of your resurrection. This is a wonderful picture. We don't often get to see the Lord behind the stone. It's like going to his wake. I appreciate the scripture that Benedict uses throughout, and he weaves throughout all the meditations. He says this, St. John, unless a grain of wheat falls into the ground and dies, it remains what? Grain of wheat. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. And then the Lord explains what he was talking about. He says, he who loves his life shall lose it. But he who hates his life in this world will keep it for eternal life. St. Paul says there's two things you can do with a seed. I got a seed here. There it is. Right there. Do you see it? That's how important it is. St. Paul says you can either gamble with it and throw it in the ground, or you can hold on to it tight. This is mine. You can crush it up, add a little oil, bake it, and prepare the smallest piece of bread you've ever seen in your life. You can sit back and have your last supper. And then it's done. He who loves his life, the Greek word there for life is not physical life. It is not spiritual life, zoe. He uses a very specific word, psuche, the ability to choose. This was the struggle of Jesus as he enters into Gethsemane when he says, my soul is greatly troubled unto death. He's going to have to make a decision. He's going to have to make a decision. And he did it for us as an example. The best way to explain this, and you would understand this, it's sung by a beautiful voice, blue eyes, wonderful lyrics, Paul Anka. It rides upon a beautiful melody and it goes like this. And now the end is near. I face the final coin. Now picture this man, not here. Picture him standing at the gate of heaven. The end is near. I face the final curtain. My friend, I'll say it clear. I'll state my case for which I'm certain. I've lived a life that's full. Welcome to the villages. I've traveled each and every highway, and Lord, much more than this, I did it my way. My soul, my life, it gets worse. What is a man? What has he got but not himself? That he has nothing. To say the things he truly feels in this line hurts. To say the things he truly feels are not the words of one who kneels. You will never catch me kneeling. I'm a self-made man. All the record shows I took the blows. But I did it my way. To
Today's scripture says what? Every knee shall bow in heaven, on earth, and under the earth. You will see Satan drop to his knees. Every knee shall bow. This will be a great time to drop the knee, wouldn't it? Pray this prayer in silence with me. I'll give you the words. So for us, he waits in faith, and like the grain of wheat, he throws his life into the ground, so that the outer shell will break, and then the real life comes true. He's the first of many brethren. This is the best part. There's a wonderful psalm that says, because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Let's see, let's see, it's almost again. Technology. It's fine. What happens is his body rises right out of the tomb. And you see his face. Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Because I know he holds my future. Life is worth living because he lives. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for tonight. We thank you, Lord, for the mystery of the cross, that you hide it, that it's not obvious. But if I come as a child, you will disclose it to me. You will reveal it to my heart. Thank you, Lord, for the mystery of the cross. Prepare our hearts for this Holy Week, Holy Thursday, Good Friday, Holy Saturday, when he goes down into the darkness and he frees those for many years have been chained, that we may all rise with him on resurrection morning. Seal what you did tonight. We ask all this through your Son, Jesus Christ, even the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you, people. If you want to, I hate stopping this. All the songs that I sang tonight are on a CD called The Way of the Cross. And my beautiful wife, remember the ring? She will be out there. And Deacon John has something to say.
Brothers and sisters, on behalf of this choir and the music director, Roger Grenier, we thank you for coming. Our ushers are now taking up a love offering for this wonderful evening. Amen.
Thank you, Father Sebastian, playing the organ there.